after this, all this deal closes, you'll be the largest shareholder in Seaspan. Obviously, you're doubling down on it. Why did you want to go deeper into this business?
Well, the key reason, Amanda, as I may have mentioned to you earlier, is that we're backing David Sokol and the Washington family that is a very large shareholder, the controlling shareholder, and we like to back them. David's track record is simply outstanding. And, you know, David, in the 20-year time period between 1991 and 2011, the 20 years, he built a company called MidAmerican. And the revenues went from something like $100 million plus to $11 billion. Assets went from $500 million to $50 billion. But the most important statistic, of course, is the return on average shareholders' equity, Amanda. On average, it was 23% over that 20-year period. Just simply outstanding. There's not too many businessmen that I've seen with results like that.
All right. Well, David, I hope your ears are burning. In terms of the vote of confidence here, you just closed an acquisition. Will this allow you to make more of those as the industry consolidates?
Yes, Amanda. The we closed, as you say, the GCI transaction, which was about a $1.6 billion a couple of months ago. And frankly, our ability to do that was highly enhanced by Fairfax's initial investment. But having Fairfax now with this additional $500 million investment in Seaspan, coupled with the Washington family's enormous investment, we've got two of the best foundational investors you could have in an infrastructure business like this. And, you know, not unlike MidAmerican Energy, this is an infrastructure business. And a lot of people look at it and think that the returns aren't that good. But the reality is if you invest at the right time, if you grow assets properly, if you buy them in the right instances, and then you run them really well, the opportunities are significant to create real long-term cash flow and shareholder value. But we're, you know, couldn't be happier with what Fairfax is doing with us, and to both have Prem and Dennis Washington as our key shareholders is going to make, I think, the next 10 years a lot of fun.
There's been, David, a bear market in this industry for some time, but Seaspan, like some others in the industry, actually ran into balance sheet issues. This was a turnaround when you came to it. Is the turnaround over?
Yes. You know, last year we had to really focus on cash flow, pay down as much debt as we could. We raised equity, and it was a painful process because the company had over-leveraged itself. But we got that done. We demonstrated to both the credit rating agencies, our debt holders, and our equity holders that we're serious about running the business the right way for the long haul. We did have to change out the senior management of the company, but that's complete now. Really solid team focused on what's essential in business, which is attention to detail and execution. And so really pleased Bing Chin has jumped in and making real differences every day. Our new CFO, Ryan Courson, is doing a great job. And frankly, the whole team is gathering around the momentum that gets created when everybody realizes that we're all in it for the same purpose.
And Prem, in terms of what originally drew you to this particular company, there were many to choose from if you were looking for a value and a business that was struggling. What was it particularly about Seaspan that attracted you in the first place and makes you want to invest $500 million more?
Well, Amanda, as I mentioned earlier, the key reason is we're very management-oriented. And David, I've known for at least 6 years. And prior to that, I'd followed him at MidAmerican. His track record is simply outstanding. I mean, taking a company with $100 million in revenue, a little more than $100 million, to $11 billion, and at the same time having a 23% return on equity on average over 20 years is one of the best track records I've come. So when we had an opportunity, Amanda, when David called us and said, there's a possibility here, our first deal, debt and warrants, sometime in December, we jumped on it. And a sign of a good partnership, Amanda, is that, I don't think it took more than 5 or 10 minutes, Dave, to get the deal done in terms of negotiation, I'm thinking. And more recently, Amanda, we came up with the idea that this was a terrific platform for David, and if he had if he converted the warrants into equity, that's $500 million, and keep that debenture of $500 million, so it's $1 billion, one of the biggest investments we've had. That David would be, David and the management team for Seaspan would be in a tremendous position to consolidate the industry, and that's the reason we did it.